Hello friends and welcome back to our channel. In this PowerPoint animation tutorial, you will learn to use a few basics of using shapes in PowerPoint. You will also learn how and when to use the change shape command available under the Edit Shape of Shape Format tab. Before we begin, first we would like to thank our Patreon for their contributions. So, here we have 6 slides in this presentation animating different shapes, and we created all these slides in just a few minutes using the change shape command. Let's begin with the first slide, where we are spinning oval shapes around the static circles. You can also watch our tutorial on how to create realistic wave animation in PowerPoint, in which we had used the same technique. If you look into the second slide, then it seems identical to the first slide, but in this slide, the larger ovals are also spinning a bit along with the smaller oval shapes. In PowerPoint, if you apply the spin effect to an oval shape, then you are not going to notice either if it is spinning or not during the slideshow. You can change the outline style to see the movement. If you group another shape with the oval, then it will change the anchor point position, and now you can notice the spin effect in both the shapes, and that is what we did on the second slide. We took an oval shape and removed the fill color. Then we take another oval shape and grouped it with the first one, which changed the anchor point position, and upon applying the spin effect, you can notice a movement in both shapes. Even though the first slide seems identical to the second, but there is no movement in the larger oval shapes. So here if we open the selection pane, then you can notice that we have an oval and hollow shape under each of the groups, but also has an oval shape outside of the groups. As we don't want the larger oval shapes to spin along with the smaller ones, we place the oval shape inside the hollow shape. And then we hide the hollow shape using no fill and no outline color. We then applied the spin emphasis effect to the hollow and small oval group. And then we placed another oval shape on top. During the slideshow, it seems like the smaller oval is spinning around the larger oval, but in reality, the hollow shape is spinning, which is not visible. Once we have these 3 shapes ready, now we can make more duplicates having an exact distance by first selecting them first, and then holding down the control key, and then dragging and dropping while maintaining a distance between them. Now, you don't need to drag and drop while holding the control key to make further copies. Instead, you can press the control plus Y key, or F4 key to repeat the last command. The last thing that we need to do is to add a delay timing between all the spin animations through the animation pane. The time duration we used for the spin effect is 2 seconds, and we added a delay of 0.10 seconds between each of the effects. Like, 0.10 seconds delay for the second effect, 0.20 seconds for the third effect, and so on. See the slideshow, and there you have it. Now, let's talk about using the change shape command. We used the change shape command on the second slide, where we only have 2 grouped shapes, and we want both to spin during the slideshow. So, to quickly create more animated slides having the same effect but on different shapes, first we duplicated the slide. Then we selected all the shapes on the slide by pressing the Ctrl A key, and then move to Shape Format, Edit Shape, and then Change Shape. From the list, select any of the desired shapes and there you have totally a new animation ready in seconds. By repeating the same steps, we can create as many animations as possible. I hope you will find this video informative, and you might have learned something new. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting. Subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks a lot for watching and have a great day.